Okay, we are back to loops. You're already familiar with apply to each, but we dig a little bit more into it. And then we will get into something a bit more interesting called do until. First, let's see the difference. Apply to each is typically used to navigate through all the items in a collection, in all the records that they are returned from, for example, a SharePoint list, all the files that we received from a library, all the items in an array. So basically, when you give it a collection, it doesn't discriminate. It just literally navigates through every single item in an array, in a list, or anything that has more than one item inside it, which, to be honest, in Power Automate, they are all arrays. Remember that square bracket? While when we talk about do until, this guy does not have end. It keeps on repeating a certain number of actions until a certain condition is there. Let's start with apply to each in an example, and then we will do a do until. If we go to our flow designer, I want to create a new flow. And this time, yeah, let it be the instant flow. Again, I want to push a button. I call it loop demo. And manually trigger a flow, and I click on create. When I run this trigger, let me create an array and navigate through all the items. That is basically the simplest way that we can use apply to each. So if I say new item, I would say initialize variable. I call it my array. Type is going to be an array, and the value is going to be square bracket, and inside it I put items in double quote. So I call it, for example, Ali, James, Sarah, and finally Alice. Let me just save it. So this one created an array. Now let's navigate through all of them. Now it's time to do something about it. Imagine I want to insert every single item in this list to SharePoint. So let's go to SharePoint and create a dummy list for it. Inside SharePoint, any website that you have access to and you are the admin. So I just create a new app. This app is going to be a custom list, and I call it My Friends. And I click on create. So My Friends is a custom list that has only one title, which is okay because there is only one value for each item. So I just want to insert the value for the list items inside SharePoint. So our target is Power Automate Workshop website. The list is going to be My Friend, and every item in that array should be inserted into this list. So in this case, I go back to my Power Automate. You're already familiar with add item to SharePoint, but before I do that, I need to have an apply to each to navigate through every single item in that array. So I go for apply to each. It comes under control, and then it says, okay, what do you want to navigate through? Give me an array, give me a list, give me a table, anything like that. So I click on here and I say, I have my array, which has multiple items in it. Can you please navigate through every single item? And then inside it, I go for SharePoint. And when I select SharePoint, I would say create item. There we go. I pick up the SharePoint site, just like before. Power Automate Workshop. List name is going to be My Friends. And I only have one title. So I click on the my title. And if I scroll to apply to each, I can pick current item, which is just one single value. And I can say save. Fantastic. So what I expect from this, when I run it, when I push the button to run it, it should go there and get every single item in this array. Apply to each should navigate through every single one of them. And it should create a record inside this My Friends list for every single item in this array. So let me click on Save and we test it. Click Test and I click on Continue. Run flow, happily ever after. Takes a while because it goes through a loop, which is fine. Successfully completed, I go back to my SharePoint and you see all the items are added to SharePoint. Fantastic. Of course, the array that I have can be more complex. Instead of an array of a string, I can have array of objects. So in this case, the apply to each behaves a little bit differently, which is out of question at the moment. I just wanted to see how apply to each works when we have an array inside the flow. Of course, the same way, if I want to read items from another SharePoint list, so let me go back to my SharePoint, and this time I go for products list demo, the list that we already worked with, and I want to get the items in this products list demo. In this case, again, I can come back here and I can use SharePoint. Again, get items, pick up the site, Power Automate Workshop. I pick up the list name, which is products list demo, and this get items returns exactly the same way that initialize variable presents an array. Get items also presents an array, but this one is an array, again with square brackets, of objects, of JSON objects. In this course, we really don't want to dig into that, but if we want to work on every single item that we get from this one, we can always use apply to each, just like before. And again, it says, where should I get the items from? And this time I would say, get it from the list of items. And of course, when I go inside it, even if I want to send email, and I use send an email v2, just like before, and I want to send it to myself, subject is going to be, for example, test, and I will put the category value. And this time, actually, it gets a category value from the value of the apply to each, which is basically the current item. So here, the value is the same as current item that we have here. Good. So I would say the product is, and I just save it, and if I run it, it adds a few records to this list again, to the My Friends list, and then gets all the items in this list and apply to each again, navigates through all the items that they are coming from get items, and sends an email that the title contains the category and the body contains the title, which is a product name. So let's give it another shot, test and continue. Run flow, done. So again, it takes a while. Perfect. So apply to each worked. So let's go back here and see, first of all, in my new library, which is My Friends, I should have more items, which makes me quite happy because it seems like I have more friends. But the reality is that it's the duplicate, which means there is another bug in my code that I have to take care of it rather than parting with friends. Now, let's go to the mailbox, Outlook, open a new tab. And these are the items that we get. Electronics, laptop, electronics, microphone, sports, tennis ball, so on and so forth. So basically, long story short, we have loops that it can navigate through every single item in an array, a collection, list of records, or a table, whatever you want to call it. At the end, when every single one of them come inside Power Automate, They are all arrays. So far we learned about apply to each. Now let's get into do until control.